Yes, it's true. This story does contain perhaps the most cringeworthy line of any of the stories. I guess that depends on person reading it. Would you like me to read it? It's, of course, the line, "It was 2 a.m. and he had been masturbating in the break room when a transistor radio emerging from the skull of a tapir flicked on and started blaring local sports scores. I saw a tapir at the zoo," and of course this is the second time we have referenced the zoo. This goes back to my fascination with animals, both as pets and as things to gawk at as if they are entertainment. We did not have anything like this, although I would be lying if I said that some of the animals weren't completely majestic, the tapir being one of the most unusual animals I've ever seen. I don't know if it was necessary for the zookeeper to be masturbating at the beginning of this story, but I thought, someone's got to be there, staying there while the animals sleep, or they do whatever they do at night. All night long, someone has to be on that shift. It's just natural. It means nothing, really. It's just that person's choice, that character's choice. That in itself is not tempting to be symbolic of anything else.